Hi, welcome to the first in a series of several research papers based on the analysis of the cannabis industry. Here we focus on the impact of a marijuana state treatment on economic development. That if marijuana is legalized, how would it affect the economic development? Speaking of marijuana first, it's still federally illegal under the Schedule 1 Controlled Substances Act, amongst other hard drugs such as heroin, crack, cocaine, and meth. USA is the third country after Uruguay and Canada to legalize weed recreationally. Other places around the world famous for marijuana are Netherlands, Denmark, Jamaica, Portugal, Costa Rica, and Spain. Marijuana is also available illegally in many states and countries. Motivation for the research question. Why should we legalize marijuana? Because once we legalize it, the states can collect taxes and the tax can be used for the economic development. And how large would this positive impact be or negative impact? That's the motivation for the research question. Once it's legalized, the share of the illicit market also reduces. I would assume the crime would go down as well. That's my hypothesis for the research papers conducted after this one. And we also know that the DEA spends a lot of money for drug policy enforcement, billions of dollars. So once it's legalized and the illicit market size has been reduced, these expenditures will be reduced as well, which will impact, again, increase the economic development. It's estimated that the cannabis revenue by 2022 will increase to $23 billion. Before we jump in the research paper, let's take a small microscopic example to see why is this important. Colorado legalized weed in 2014, and till now they have generated revenues of $1.8 billion. Imagine what would happen when all the states legalize it and the entire population starts smoking marijuana. Existing literature on this research topic is barely existent, and even if it is, it's either in the field of political or health economics, crime related, and those areas. The research on macroeconomic analysis is none. There are a few firms, notably BDSA and NCIA, which have collected some good, significant data on the cannabis industry. And one notable institution is the Colorado State University at Pueblo. Their a program of Institute of Cannabis Research accepts all the research papers on cannabis industries, including a financial and economic in nature. But let's look at that first. This is the 2019 thing for a brochure for a cannabis of research at CSU. Most of them, if you see here, are related to either political, criminal, or health effects. None of them have analyzed the macroeconomic impacts. This is the first paper in the field to do so. As we spoke about Colorado first, as we can see, the retail sales tax is increasing significantly, and so is the excise tax. That means that the production is increasing a lot, which means people have started smoking weed a lot since the past 2 years. Marijuana production has saw a significant increase. Speaking of our economic analysis, we use real GDP per capita to analyze. And as we can see here, California has a very high real GDP per capita as compared to the states which haven't legalized it yet. We'll talk about it in a few slides. Yeah, so this paper is the first of its kind to analyze the macroeconomic impacts of the legalization of marijuana. States legalize marijuana in different stages. Either it's illegal, then they move on to decriminalize it. And once they decriminalize, they also have some low CBD programs for health analysis, which are not open to the public. And then they move on to legalize it medically and then recreationally. This paper wants to analyze the impact of legalization of marijuana in different states and different levels and their impact on the log of real GDP per capita. The data has been collected from NCSL with the state legislatures and Bureau of Economic Analysis. for other microeconomic indicators. Other informal sources for additional industry insights includes a lot of articles from newspapers and MDBS analytics, as we talked about it before, and MJB. This data analyzes the regression models from 1997 to 2019. The other indicators which we use are micro indicators such as GDP, compensation, taxes, subsidies, inflation, and interest rates. We include several dummy variables as well, which takes value 0 or 1 based on the status of the state, which, as I talked about before, is illegal, decriminalized, medical, or recreational. We have 4 states which have marijuana illegal in their states, completely illegal: Idaho, Kansas, Nebraska, and South Dakota. These are the states which have decriminalized it with some variations in their several low CBD programs. As we see, there are a lot of states which have legalized it medically, and getting a med card is pretty easy, trust me. And we have a few 11 states which, and District of Columbia, which have legalized it recreationally, including California. Here, as we can see, the real GDP per capita increases as they move on to legalize it, as more and more people can consume it. The difference between illegal and decriminalized, it's not much, but the difference between the status 3 and 4 is a lot. The empirical approach: I use fixed effects and difference approach to analyze this model. We use the different treatment status for the medical status 1, 2, 3, and 4. I use approval year instead of the effective date to include the sentiment effects. And then our main interpretation would come from that would be the difference after the treatment in the states which legalized and those who didn't. We also include several other microeconomic indicators, as we included before. One thing I'd like to point out is that we use a per capita approach because we want to see the individual impact, because it's driven by consumer demand. The assumptions for this model would be parallel pretrends, which we know is not true. The limitations of this model are spillover effects and cross-boundary. SAFE is the Safe and Fair Enforcement Act that would protect the financial institutions of financing the cannabis firms. That would mean across border financing, which also impact the GDP and real GDP, as we know. More is Marijuana Opportunity Reinvestment and Expungement Act that would decriminalize marijuana at the federal level. But this paper focuses on the policy statement or the policy treatment on the states. When we include the federal level treatment, that would cause a lot of biasness. A population is also collected. The population data is collected through a census every 10 years. So we have to rely on the estimates for the years in between. The strengths and weaknesses of the data would be that our data is limited to a certain number of years. Since California turned medical in 96, in order to observe the pre-trends, we lack data as of now. And let's look at the results as of now. We have two models, a baseline and the second one where we include more marijuana controls. As we can see here, as the states turn medical here, the real GDP per capita increases by 7%. And when we include the controls, it increases by 3.79%. A notable observation from this model would be when the states turn recreational, the percentage change in the real GDP per capita is significantly higher at 23.43% and 20.7% respectively. One of the controls we include is the criminal record clearing program, which means that if anyone was convicted before, their records will be cleared and it will only be charged as a misdemeanor with a fine of $130, say for example in California. And this has a significant impact on the real GDP per capita as well, as it increases by 8.18%. We use robustness to calculate and include the heteroscedasticity in the data. Let's include the second model in the paper, which is a fixed effects model. As we see here, we include all the different categories or the dummies for the status. One is for illegal, decriminalized, medical, and recreational. As we can see, in overall, when the states turn recreational, it's significantly higher than all the other three statuses. That means all the states should move on to legalize it. And one observable thing is the total mean of the variable MS in the data is 2.8, which means that all the states are, on an average, the country is moving towards legalizing it, at least medically. They should legalize it recreationally. And here we also include a state fixed effects. And in the models where we include the state fixed effects, we see a very large, a very higher R square, because it captures the variation in the real GDP per capita. As we know, it's impacted by the other macroeconomic state indicators as well. We also include year fixed effects, state fixed effects, industry fixed effects, and a two-way fixed effects model, including year and state. Let's look at some additional analysis and robustness. Just a disclaimer, these are preliminary results and these are subject to scrutiny. I would be happy to include some feedback on these models. First, we look in the definitive for medical law state treatment. Here in the baseline regression, we can see that only the states which legalized it after had a GDP of 2.8% higher than those who didn't. This is for the pre-trends. But when we check for the beta 3 coefficient, as we saw before, the change in the GDP, the percentage change in the real GDP per capita is nearly around zero when it's legalized medically. We have like different models, including different controls, as you can see here. Again, a notable point would be to see that wherever the fixed effects are included, the R-square increases because the variation is captured quite nicely. This was for medical marijuana difference in difference. We also see for recreational. Here, as we can see again, all the states which legalized marijuana recreationally see an overall higher real GDP per capita. Our beta 3 coefficient unfortunately got omitted because of multicollinearity, as it correlates with the AYR variable here. So we'll analyze the AYR variable instead. In the baseline treatments and all the other following models with the fixed effects, we see that a post-treatment difference in the economic development of these states captured by the real GDP per capita, it increases by 18.6% and around 5.7% when we have states state fixed effects. Thank you for your time, and the full paper with detailed results and interpretation shall be released next week, and a follow-up for the remaining series of this analysis on the cannabis industry. Thank you.